I am Sandeep. I am going to show you how to install NS2 and AODV protocol simulation in NS2. Now to start with NS2, to install NS2 we need three commands, that is sudo apt get install NS2. Enter. It will ask you for the password, system password. Now press S. It will take few seconds to download. Now network simulator NS2 is for simulating the protocols, network protocols like TCP, UDP, AODV, DSR. All these kind of protocols we can simulate by using NS2. It will allow us to configure the number of nodes and the kind of protocol which we can write in C++. Actually it uses two languages here, one is C++ and the other one is scripting language called TCL. Now once after installing NS2, you need to install NAM, Network Animator. To install that, sudo apt get install NAM. Enter. Yes. After this we need to install XCroff also by using the command sudo apt get install XCroff. Now we'll check once whether our NS2 is installed or not by using a command called NAM. What is NAM stands for is NAM is nothing but network animator, where we can see the a simulation of like how nodes will move from one place to other nodes and how the packets are going to exchange the how the nodes are going to exchange the packets. Now the thing which you are seeing now is a network animator. Here is the GUI where we can create our nodes and we can make the node movement as well as the packet transfers. Now today we'll see AODV simulation. I have taken the code and named it with a file called AODV18.tcl. Now what I have to do to run this, I need to follow two steps. One is to execute this TCL file. Once after the TCL file, the TCL will looks like something like this, where you can configure the number of nodes, the screen size, and X and Y dimensions, where the node dimensions coordinates will be given. Now here in this demonstration, I have taken 12 mobile nodes, and the protocol which we are seeing routing protocol is AODV. AODV protocol is a reactive protocol, and here if you see the time of simulation ends, it is 150 seconds. That means our simulation is going to be happen for 150 seconds, and it will also allow you to define the initial position of the nodes, and here I am using this AODV protocol packets are sent using TCP connections, TCP between node 2 and node 11. That is, my source node is 2 and the destination node is 11. And we'll see how the packets are going to transfer from node to node 11 later. First, we'll execute that AODV18.tcl file. To execute that, the command is like ns space AODV18.tcl. Once after this has been executed, change the directory. NS AODV18.tcl. Yeah. Now after getting this, three files will be created. One is with .nam and the other two files are .tr. Those three files are on the desktop. Now what I'll do is I'll delete and I'll try to execute those files. Again, those three files will be created. So to simulate my AODV, I need to run that or execute that .nam file. The command is as follows: NAM AODV NAM. The file is NAM test AODV dot NAM. Now, this is the thing which I told you, like network animator, where we can see that mobile nodes which we have created. NAM test AODV not. Now I have created the environment with 12 mobile nodes ranging from 0 to 11. As we know that in the .tcl file we have configured, that is we have established TCP connection between the node 2 and node 11. That is my source node is going to be 2 and the destination node is going to be 11. Now the packets are going to be transferred from 2 to 11. If you observe, slowly the packets are going to be transferred from 2 to 11. Before going to that, we'll see how AODV is going to be worked. AODV is a kind of protocol, like reactive protocol. Mean to say, whenever it wants to send the packets, then only it finds the path to the destination. Since this environment is mobile ad hoc network, the nodes are going to be moved from time to time. So there won't be any fixed infrastructure and it has to check whether how it can send the packets to the destinations by communicate with the nearest nodes available to that. Now the packets are moving to 11 as soon as up to the 11 node is available in the region of 2. Now once the node 11 is out of the region from 2, what it is going to do is it is going to send packets to 11 node via 9. Here the node 9 acts as a router. Now whenever the packet destination packet is sent to 11, it will check what is the nearest node available to that. The nearest node available to that is node 9. So it is going to send the packets to node 9, and from node 9 to node 11 the packets are going to be transferred. This destination is, the destination path is found in AODV by by flooding the packets RREQ, like request packets it is going to flood through in the network, and the reply path it is going to get back. Now we'll see the configuration file once, and we'll also look into the file how the things will work if we change the number of nodes to 50. If you see here, the node movements, now we'll change this to 10. We'll take big 50. And we'll look into the ones. We have to close this again and we have to execute again. Since we have modified the .tcl file, we need to re-execute and we need to execute that NAM file. NS AODV18.tcl. NAM test AODV.NAM. Now we see it consists of 50 nodes. Now, as I told earlier, we didn't change the source and destination nodes, and the TCP communication between 2 and level is used to send the packets. Now 2 is sending packets to node level, node 11. Now when node 2 is moving away from 11, it is trying to send the packets via 32, because 32 is very near to node level as well as node 2. So now the 38 node is somewhat near to node 2 and it is going to send packets to node 32, from there to node 32, and from there to node 11. So in this way, the node 38 and node 32 are going to be act as routers. Thank you.